Are we at risk of losing our digital information over time? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago that I think is very timely. Today, lots of information is being stored electronically. Years ago, it was on books that lasted hundreds of years, if you wanted. Try reading a 1984 3.5-inch floppy disk, or worse, a 5.5-inch. The 8-inchers are before my computing time. I saw them on War Games. The ones with the reels that stopped and started are really unreadable. I also used a tape drive on a Commodore VIC 20. If I did not hoard it, it would all be unreadable, as I have not used this stuff in 34 years. So, are humans in danger of losing knowledge this way? Magnetic media degrades faster than paper books, doesn't it? First of all, I think you do raise an excellent point. It's not a given that what we create today will be here in 100 years or 200 years. But the same is actually true of books, paper, physical media. It's actually much more complicated than a lot of people think. There's something called survivorship bias, which means we attribute characteristics to the things that have survived more than we do to the entire body of things that might have existed. For example, one of the responses I get to one of my videos on what's the best long-term storage media is repeatedly I get people saying, well, stone tablets lasted forever. No, they didn't. A few did. Absolutely. Those are wonderful. But of the thousands, perhaps millions of stone tablets that were created in ages past, only a few have survived. So let's talk a little bit about the issues. To begin with, there's the physical format, the one that you raised, the 3.5-inch disks, the 5.25s, and so forth. This is all about how the information is stored. I do indeed have a couple of backup tapes that I'm no longer able to read. Not sure what I'm going to do with those. If someday there needs to be something recovered from those tapes, I'm sure there are ways that can be devised. But right now, There's really no reason to believe that any of the formats we're using today will be here in 100 years, 500 years, or whatever. And yet, there is a technique that would guarantee that the information on the things we have today will still be around in 100 or 500 or more years. And that's simply this: copy. That is one of the reasons that I find digital information so much more lucrative and stable and long-lasting than so many of the alternatives people bring up. You can copy digital data instantly, or at least very quickly. So, as technology progresses, as new things come along, copy the data from the old format before it's no longer supported to a new format that is going to be around for a long time. For example, I used to have a bunch of backup stuff on CDs. CDs deteriorate over time at varying rates. My approach was a couple of years ago to copy all of those CDs to a hard disk. That hard disk, of course, is backed up, so I now have two copies of everything. But the point is, that hard disk will be around for a lot longer than I can read my CDs. Someday, that hard disk will be old technology of some sort. So, we'll copy from the hard disk to whatever is the current technology of the day. Yes, it's something you have to remember to do. It's something that makes sense in the long run, and it's something that actually isn't really all that hard to do anymore. Juggling my CDs was a pain because there were so many of them. But now, when it comes time for me to copy that hard drive to something else, well, I plug into something else and I just say, hey, go copy. The machine will do it for me. So, the key here is to, for physical storage media, keep moving forward. Keep iterating forward to newer hardware that will continue to be supported for more years. I'm pretty sure that when the Enterprise comes around on Star Trek, they're not going to have a SATA interface for my old hard drive. But they will have the ability, or they will have the place to store digital data. Somebody will have copied it. Now, the other issue, of course, is the formats of the actual files. And this is actually a little bit trickier. I have a couple of different opinions on this. One is that every digital format can be figured out. It can be reverse engineered. It's just work. So if 10 years from now, you have a file that is using an obscure file format, it would be possible to reverse engineer and transform that file into something else. Would it be worth it? I can't say. I'm sure that historians of the future may decide that, yeah, you know, that thing over there, that was so important that we really do need to reverse engineer and come up with a new interface that will read that file format. On the other hand, I am absolutely convinced that our most common file formats today, things like PDF, ZIP, potentially even Word documents and Excel spreadsheets, these are so ubiquitous today that the ability to read them will be here for a very, very long time. Probably a lot longer than the ability to create them, because we'll probably have moved on to something else. But because there's so much documentation, so much information that is stored in these formats, and because these formats are generally open, I see no reason that we couldn't always have a fairly easy way to at least read the information that's been stored in these files. Honestly, all we're really talking about here is another form of backing up. Copying data forward, well, it's making a copy. You're stacking the deck in favor of using a newer technology that will last, say, another 20 years or another 30 years. In another 20 years, you choose the format that at that point will last another 20 or 30 years. Now, one of the things that a lot of people don't think about is that this is not a new problem. Data preservation is absolutely nothing new. In the past, think about it. One of the things that monks did 500, 800 years ago was copy documents, painstakingly, by hand, because the originals that they were working from were deteriorating. They very carefully made copies. That's where, to me, digital storage makes complete sense. Because what might have taken a monk a month to copy, again, painstakingly by hand, can be copied in seconds and distributed around the world. So, what's the bottom line? Well, you can probably guess. I believe strongly in digitizing your data. Because once it's digitized, once you've got it scanned or whatever, scanned or OCR'd or whatever, then you have it in a form that can be processed by algorithms. And it's those algorithms today and in the future that will allow us to continue to access and view the various files and information that we have today. And of course, once you've scanned or OCR'd or whatever, back it up. That's something else that digital data has going for it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/15475. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.